precipitation of insoluble salt. Consider a beaker containing AgCl in water. So what is the reaction taking place? Since we have a value of Ksp of AgCl, that means AgCl will dissociate partially to Ag plus and Cl minus. And this reaction, this is an equilibrium, so we have two directions. In direction one, K of the reaction equal Ksp, which is very low. That means dissociation with direction one is limited. So the question now, what is the possibility if we mix Ag plus and Cl minus? So the question, what would happen when Ag plus and Cl minus are mixed together with known concentration? So in this case, we favor the reaction in direction two. So Ag plus plus Cl minus in direction two, the reaction is advanced since the reaction in direction one is limited. But we have three possibilities. Ag plus plus Cl minus added in known concentrations react together to form AgCl, but this quantity of AgCl formed is determined in a way that we don't have appearance of precipitate. So the first case, we have AgCl soluble, so no precipitate is formed. The second possibility, that Ag plus plus Cl minus at known concentrations react in advanced reaction to form AgCl, but we are at the beginning of precipitation. So this is the second possibility. The third, Ag plus plus Cl minus reacts together to form a real precipitate AgCl that can be observed. So when we add Ag plus and Cl minus, by theory, we have formation of AgCl solid, but according to the concentrations of Ag plus and Cl minus, we have three possibilities. First, no precipitate is observed. Second, we are at the beginning of the precipitation. Third, we have a real precipitation. So the three cases depend on the concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus mixed initially. So what is the strategy, or what are the steps in order to know which of the three possibilities is which of the three possibilities occurs? First of all, we have to write the reaction. The reaction taking place is Ag plus plus Cl minus is advanced in direction one that give AgCl salt. So the reaction is advanced in the direction of formation of AgCl and is limited in the direction of dissociation of AgCl. Determine K of the reaction. K for the reaction is equal 1 over Ksp, K of the reaction is very high. So as we said, this reaction is advanced in this direction. Is the reaction complete? We can say K very high implies complete. Or if the value is not too high, we can say that the reaction is advanced. Which ions are spectator? Pay attention that we mix NaCl with AgNO3. So we mix Na plus and Cl minus with Ag plus and NO3 minus. We look, what are the possible reactions? Na plus can react with NO3 minus to give Na and NO3. No Ksp given implies Na and NO3 will dissociate to give the initial ions. So we don't have reaction between Na plus, Na plus, plus NO3 minus, no reaction. Since Na plus react with NO3 minus to give Na and NO3, and Na and NO3, no Ksp given, so Na and NO3 is a strong electrolyte that will redissociate to Na plus and NO3 minus. So we don't have reaction. The second possibility is that we have reaction Ag plus plus Cl minus, yes, since we have Ksp of AgCl. So only we have reaction between the ion Ag plus and the ion Cl minus. The other ions Na plus and NO3 minus are called spectator ion in this type of reaction. The last step, and this is very important in the calculation, when we mix NaCl, we have a certain concentration of Na plus and Cl minus in beaker 1. In beaker 2, we have AgCl, we have definite concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus. Pay attention, when you mix NaCl with AgNO3, so you mix two solutions, the V total will be changed. In this case, you will have dilution at T equals 0. Thus, the student forget always to calculate the new concentrations of ions at T equals 0 after dilution. So pay attention to determine the new concentration of the species in the final solution after dilution. So what are the ions we mix? Ag plus, NO3 minus, Na plus, Cl minus. Between Na plus and NO3 minus, we don't have reaction since no Ksp is given for Na and NO3. It will redissociate to ions. So we will have reaction between Ag plus and Cl minus to give AgCl, and Na plus and NO3 minus are spectator. K for this reaction is calculated to be 1 over Ksp. Ksp of AgCl is given equals 0.625 10 to the power 10 K of the reaction. The value of K is very large, is very high, so we can consider that this reaction is complete. Okay, so Ag plus plus Cl minus will give AgCl. Then AgCl will redissociate to Ag plus and Cl minus. According to the volume of the solution we mix, okay, we may dissociate AgCl to Ag plus and Cl minus, so we could not observe the formation of precipitate. In this case, we will say that by theory, Ag plus and Cl minus should form AgCl precipitate, But according to the concentration initially we used of Ag plus and Cl minus, we did not observe the formation of the precipitate AgCl. This is the first possibility. The second possibility is to say that Ag plus and Cl minus mixed at definite concentrations will form AgCl at the starting of the precipitation. We are at the starting. Or the third case, according to the concentration mix, you observe clearly the formation of AgCl solid. So the three possibilities depends on the concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus used. So depends on the new concentrations at T equals zero of Ag plus and Cl minus after dilution. So now we have to pass to the calculation. What to do? First, you have Ag plus in beaker one, and you have Cl minus in beaker two. You mixed, you obtain Ag plus in solution equal C initial V initial, which is in beaker one, divided by V total. So this is concentration at T equals zero after dilution. By the same way, also you calculate Cl minus. I will call Cl minus initial. This is Ag plus initial in the solution. Okay. So this is an equilibrium. You know, for any equilibrium, is characterized by equilibrium constant K. Suppose you have concentrations, you calculated Q, which is the ratio of concentrations. And you said in the equilibrium, if Q is less than K, so the reaction will proceed in direction one. If Q is exactly equal K, you are at equilibrium. And if Q is greater than K, the reaction will proceed in direction two. This is the shifting of the equilibrium we studied in the chapter equilibrium. Suppose you have a reaction, you don't know this reaction is before equilibrium or at equilibrium or after equilibrium. So what to do? According to the concentrations given in the exercise, you calculate the thermodynamic ratio Q. According to the value, you compare Q with K. We studied this in the chemical equilibrium in the first semester. If Q is less than K, so the reaction will proceed in direction one. If Q is equal K, we are at equilibrium. If Q is greater than K, the reaction will shift backward, so the reaction is in direction two. We follow the same strategy. We calculate Q in this case. What is Q? Q is equal to the concentration of Ag plus in the solution and the concentration of Cl minus in the solution. So you have equal Ag plus initial at T equals zero after dilution times Cl minus initial. Don't forget that you calculated Ag plus initial and Cl minus initial by taking into consideration the dilution effect. Now you compare Q, this is direction one, this is direction two. If this Q is the ionic product, it's the product of ions. So we called it Q, or in the solubility chapter, we called it IP. This is the ionic product. If IP you calculated is less than KSP given, that means the reaction goes forward. So in the direction of dissociation of AgCl, so you did not observe precipitate. No precipitate fall. If IP is equal KSP, that means your reaction is at equilibrium, so you are at the beginning of the formation of precipitation. And if IP is greater than KSP, so you have precipitate form, since the reaction will shift backward in the direction of decreasing the solubility or in the direction of increasing the precipitation. As a conclusion, suppose you mix positive ions and negative ions, and you know that between positive ion and negative ion, you might have formation of precipitate. So what to do? First of all, look to the KSP given. Suppose KSP is given for AgCl. That means Ag plus can make reaction with Cl minus to give AgCl precipitate. The other ions that does not belong to an expression of KSP means these ions are spectators. This is a step one. Step two, by theory, Ag plus plus Cl minus will give AgCl precipitate. But the formation of the precipitation depends on the concentration of Ag plus and Cl minus used. So we calculated Ag plus at T equals zero after dilution, and we calculate Cl minus at T equals zero after dilution. This is step two. Step three, we calculate what we call IP, which is the ionic product. This is identical to Q in the equilibrium. So IP equal Ag plus initial times Cl minus initial. And we obtain a certain value of IP since we calculated the concentrations at T equals zero after dilution. This is step three, is to calculate IP. Step four now is to compare IP calculated with the KSP of AgCl. If IP is less than KSP, that means we don't have a precipitate. In other words, if you mix Ag plus and Cl minus at these concentrations, you would not have precipitation. Or IP equal KSP. So we are at the beginning of the transformation of the precipitation. Any additional Ag plus, any additional amount of Ag plus or Cl minus, that means will have a precipitate. So when IP is equal to KSP, we are at the beginning of the precipitation. And if we found IP greater than KSP, that means you should observe the formation of precipitation. So the key is the calculation of the initial concentrations at T equals zero after dilution. Suppose you add cerium 3 plus with IO 3 minus. The question, what would happen if we mix these ions? First of all, I should ask, Do we have AKSP of cerium IO3? If yes, that means we can have three possibilities. No precipitation, precipitation, or starting of that precipitation, beginning. I use always this term, decreasing arrow, in order to indicate this is precipitation. So what to do is to calculate cerium 3 plus initial and IO3 minus initial. Pay attention, T equals 0 after dilution. Okay, so we write the reaction cerium IO3, cerium 3 plus, plus IO3 minus. Why I write the reaction in this direction? Since cerium C plus, plus IO3 minus reacts, the reaction is highly advanced to form CeIO3, then CeIO3 will redissociate to Ce3 plus and IO3 minus partially. So what is KSP is given, which is equal Ce3 plus at equilibrium times as IO3 minus at equilibrium, and this KSP is given back. So I calculate IP. IP equal cerium 3 plus initial at T equals 0 after dilution times IO3 minus at T equals 0 after dilution. Now I compare IP with KSP. Suppose I obtain IP, which is equal to Q, is greater than Q, greater than KSP. Implies formation of precipitate. If Q IP is not greater than KSP, is less than KSP, no precipitation. If IP is exactly equal to KSP, so we are at the starting of the precipitation. This is a traditional solution of such type of exercises.